Hello students, in the previous video we have discussed what is the wave packet. Now in this video also we will discuss that further. So suppose this is a particle. We will see in this video how the wave packet is going to represent this particle. So in the previous video we have seen here, so like this there will be some wave packet. So what we are doing, we are denoting by certain range, right? So how we will write here, draw this much range, and out of this range all the wavelength or all the frequency will be zero. So I can draw this like here, like this. So this is the wave packet. So this is the localized disturbance of waveform. So how this will denote the particle? Now we know particle has definite position and momentum, while the waves will have certain energies and they have wavelength. Wavelength is a characteristic of the wave. We cannot localize the wave at a particular point. We can have a region of the wave, but we cannot localize at the single point. We cannot say that here is a wave, because wave will have some disturbance over the space. Some region will be there. So this is not just a single point. So how will we get the single point using this concept? So as we have discussed in the earlier video, as we will going to increase number of waves in this wave packet, this peak will get shortened and the height will be more. So instead of this we will get something like this. So this is region. So this is we call as delta x. So in this region the wave is present. In this case this is the delta x, that is in this region the wave is present. But if you look at this particle, we can say that this is at definite position x, but we cannot do that in case of waves. So we will have certain range of space or width of some space. So how we can convert this into this, so that how we can reduce this delta x to zero, so that we can say delta x tends to zero. So as we discussed, we will add number of waves in that. Suppose first wave will have k1. This is the wave vector of that particular wave. Again, if I have to add now more number of waves which are changing with delta k, so second one will have k1 plus delta k, then k1 plus 2 delta k, k1 plus 3 delta k, and so on. So as I am increasing the number of waves, I will get the shorter delta x, that is the width of that wave. The region in which the wavelength is there is getting reduced, but what we are doing at the same time, we are increasing the k is nothing but the momentum. It is related to the momentum. How? We know k is equal to 2 pi by lambda, which is wave vector, and p is nothing but h divided by lambda. Combining these two equations, we can get p is equal to h divided by 2 pi into k, which is wave vector, or we have seen this h by 2 pi is also called as reduced Planck constant, and it is given by h cut or h cross into k. So this k is directly proportional to the momentum. So this delta k, we can replace this by delta p. So do you understand where we are moving? We are moving towards the uncertainty principle. So what Heisenberg's uncertainty principle says is, we cannot measure the position and momentum simultaneously with the accuracy greater than h cross by 2, or sometimes we use just h cross to get some order of magnitude. Symbolically we can write here, delta x delta p must be greater than equal to h cross by 2. This is the statement for position momentum uncertainty relation. So what now we are going to see, we have seen the uncertainty principle for position and momentum. Now what does this tell actually is, if we are going to increase the accuracy of position measurement, that is we are reducing delta x, which is the range, so we are reducing, we are trying to reduce this, we have to add more number of waves, and so the uncertainty in momentum will be more. So as there is delta k is more or delta p is more, we cannot say which is the exact momentum of that particle. So we cannot directly measure the momentum of particle, we are measuring it from the lambda or from the k. This is the equation of that wave, psi of x t is equal to a, which is the normalization constant, exponential of, this is the imaginary part, kx minus omega t. But now what we have discussed is, we have not just one wave, we have lot of waves, we have number of waves. Say we have infinite number of waves and we are changing k. So this is not just one wave, so we will add all these waves to get the wave packet. And so what we will do is, we will do integration from minus infinity to plus infinity. Now this a may be or may not be the function of k. For safety we will write this is a function of k. Then exponential of, this will be the same, I of kx minus, obviously k is a function of k, but now omega is also characteristics of that wave, which is of the wave vector k. So this omega is also depends on k, so we will write that omega of k into k. So now over what we have integrating this, over k we are integrating, k is a variable, so we will write here dk. So we will write dk here, that is the integration is over dk. So this we will call the definition of wave in the momentum space, because we are adding the waves using their momentum, or because k is nothing but related to momentum of the wave. So we will write the equation for wave packet like the integration of this, the wave packet as we have drawn earlier like this. So this is the wave packet. So all number of waves are added here to give this wave packet, to result this, and outside result will be zero. Now here obviously you can see, if we are going to shrink this, we have to add more number of waves and delta p will be more, even if the delta x is less. Suppose I want delta p very accurate, so what I can do, I can just have one wave. So I will have one wave. So in that case I know what is the exact lambda, so I will know exact p, that is momentum h cross by lambda. So delta p will be zero, and now you can see, if this has to be zero, then delta x has to be infinite in order to satisfy this relation, because if something is zero here, we cannot get any number to get some positive number. So, or suppose I am dividing here, something divided by zero will be infinite. So from this diagram also we can say that we cannot localize this particle, this can be anywhere. So because this is a one wave, so this is ranging from minus infinity to plus infinity, not like the wave packet which is localized. So this is on the entire space this wave is. So we cannot fix delta p is equal to zero. Now suppose let's see, delta x is zero. So delta x is zero, then we have here, only here we have some certain particle and wave is also localized there. Then what we have to do, we have to add lot of momentums. So infinite number of actual momentum, we have to add infinite number of waves, we have to add to get such wave. But then this is no longer remained wave. The moment of uncertainty is too high. We can say that is infinity. Because if I am adding infinite number of waves, there are infinite different k's. There are different infinite p's. So there are lot of momentums present in the single wave packet. We will still call wave packet still though it is in the same location at the certain point. So we cannot also make this zero. So that is the meaning of Heisenberg's uncertainty. We can reduce this product up to this point. We cannot go further. We can arrange one experiment such that we will have delta x minimum, but in that case delta p will be maximum. So this product cannot be less than this. It can be greater than this. So because we can add our errors from experiment, but this cannot lead to the error which is less than the product of delta x and delta p. These are, we can call errors, because these are the ranges. So this is the range delta x. So what does this mean? I don't know where the particle exactly in this region is, but for sure it is in this region. Suppose the particle is here and I said it is here. So this, the change in the position is the error, actual reading minus experimental reading, that is called the error. So this much can be the error. This product cannot be less than this. The product must be greater than this. Now, like the position and momentum uncertainty, there are more number of pairs of physical quantities which show this uncertainty relation. In general, we can say that delta A delta B is greater than or equal to, this can be equal, right? This can be equal but not less than. So greater than or equal to C by 2. So this is general case. So for momentum position uncertainty, C is the H cross. Or we can just write here C, and C can be H cross by 2. There is one more relation which is famous in quantum mechanics, and that is, I will write here, delta E delta T is greater than or equal to H cross by 2. So the delta E is the change in the energy, or just like this, the width of energies or the range of energies, E plus delta E, from E to E plus delta E. And then there is a time difference, so the T is a time, so there is the range of times. Suppose these are energy levels, so this is E, and suppose this is E plus delta E, so the range is delta E, and this can be, let's say, delta E by 2, right? So at certain time, if I have to check whether the particle is in this state or in this state, we cannot measure it further in this interval of delta T. So this is the shorter interval, then the delta E will become larger. If we have to make this small, delta T has to make larger. Similar to this case, position, momentum, uncertainty. So why this is in such a way? There is one relation called commutation relation. So if the two physical quantities are commuting with each other, then their uncertainty product will be zero. But if they are not commutating, so what they mean? If AB minus BA, which we will denote in the square bracket A comma B, this is called commutation relation. If this is zero, what does this mean? If this is zero, AB is equal to BA. In this case, momentum and position, XP minus PX. If this is zero, then there will be no uncertainty. But this does not give zero. So that gives I into H cross. So I will write here, the position momentum commutation relation is equal to I into H cross. So if this would be zero, then there will be no uncertainty. We can define position and momentum at a time, but this is not the case. So we can actually write here, if A and B commutation is equal to I into C, then this is the uncertainty relation. So this is a generalized case, but we are just looking in our syllabus. There are only two uncertainties we will study, delta S, delta P, and delta T, delta E, or delta E, delta T.